We know we have several dozen cases and we're following them closely, and we are every day hearing about more and more probable cases, so that number is likely to rise.
Health officials are closely following the spread of the Omicron variant across the country. Here in New York, dozens of people tested positive for COVID after attending an event at this convention center.
Health officials on alert as the Omicron variant spreads across the country, with cases reported in at least 17 states. 30-year-old Peter McGinn from Minnesota is one of those cases being monitored. He tested positive for the Omicron variant. McGinn is fully vaccinated and received a booster. He attended an anime convention in New York City in late November. After flying home, he learned that one friend he went to the convention with tested positive for COVID.
I was just a little taken back to the fact that I, A, had COVID, and B, it was the new one.
McGinn believes that he contracted the new variant not at the convention itself, but events after, when he and a group of about 30 people, also vaccinated, got together. Now, half of that group has tested positive for COVID. It's unclear if the Omicron variant will be more severe or spread faster than the Delta variant.
We really got to be careful before we make any determinations, but thus far, the signals are a bit encouraging regarding the severity.
But officials stress that all eligible Americans roll up their sleeves and get that booster shot.
New details about the capture of James and Jennifer Crumbly, the parents of the 15-year-old charged in the Michigan high school shooting. Authorities found the couple inside an empty commercial building Saturday after missing a court appearance to face involuntary manslaughter charges in connection with the shooting. The man who owns that building says he has a friendly relationship with the Crumblys and he invited them to stay at his art studio.
To avoid death threats and hostility that was surrounding their home,
according to the man's attorney, he was not aware that authorities were looking for the Crumblys.
He actually only learned about that the next morning when he saw on the news that the couple had been arrested at his location. The minute he actually did find out, he himself went to law enforcement and told them that they were there.
Authorities say the couple withdrew $4,000 from an ATM before the manhunt ended, but their lawyer insists the couple was not fleeing.
Our clients were absolutely going to turn themselves in. It was just a matter of logistics.
Investigators say James Crumbly purchased a gun on Black Friday, days before their son allegedly used it to kill four students at Oxford High School. One student remains hospitalized. According to prosecutors, the Crumblys resisted removing their son from school on the day of the shooting. Hours before the attack, the parents were confronted with a disturbing drawing and chilling message that said "blood everywhere," which was found on the boy's desk. In a statement, the superintendent said the teen claimed the drawing was part of a video game he was designing. The Crumblys and their son have pleaded not guilty.
They are not speaking to us, any of them, and they are all in my jail, all segregated in separate cells and constantly monitored.